There's a poem that it's my favorite poem, and I kind of live my life by it.
You know it by heart?
The last two stanzas, which are the most important to me. To take what we love inside, to carry within us an orchard, to eat not only the skin, but the shade, not only the sugar, but the days. I was born with hypophosphatemic rickets, a very rare genetic kidney disease. And as a result, I was born with deformed bones in my legs. I was not able to run. I was not able to jump. I never felt like a whole person. I was diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder when I was very little. It's used more as an adjective these days than it is an actual diagnosis, which is frustrating. It takes away a lot of the seriousness of what it is and what actually goes on in your head when it's happening. In the past few years, I've been able to channel it into things like my photography instead of obsessive counting and footsteps and sidewalk cracks. I spend so much of my days in something of a blur, a whirlwind. But when I'm in front of a table, when I'm setting things up, when I'm adjusting things here or there, when I'm able to focus that energy, everything just kind of goes blank. It's just pure bliss in my head. A few months after I started on Instagram, I was asked to do an interview. I was featured on their main blog, promoted to millions of people. It was the first time I really got a lot of exposure. A lot of people look at my art and they tell me it's messy, it's unorganized. I needed to find God and Jesus in my life. I was too dark and scary and a witch. It's funny to me because I think what you get out of art, it's a reflection of you, what you see in it that says more about you than it does the art itself. From a very young age that I was not normal. And I struggle with even knowing who I am in the first place in order to see myself as something that is whole. I'm able to find pieces of myself, fragments of myself in things that are not me. I'm able to look at a table setting and see that bruised fruit can be beautiful, that there is light and darkness, the back and forth, the poetry of it. I like to think that loneliness is like any other emotion. It's something you need to learn how to sit with, something you need to make a home out of. You need to build a floor, you need to build four walls and a ceiling. As soon as you think you're comfortable with it, you need to burn down the whole neighborhood and start again. When you're able to face that fear of being entirely isolated, entirely alone, you find a sense of freedom in yourself. There are days we live as if death were nowhere in the background. From joy to joy to joy, from wing to wing, from blossom to blossom, to impossible blossom, to sweet impossible blossom.